What's up, everybody? It's Alicia, and I am a New York State licensed cosmetologist. I am so glad you're here with me today for this video. I'm gonna take you through easy styles for straight hair that'll just make your normal straight hair look a little bit less boring. It's gonna just glam it up a little bit and add that little extra something that will make it not so, again, quote unquote, boring. So I'm gonna take you through what I would normally do. I just got out of the shower, my hair is wet. I'm gonna start off by spraying in some Bumble and Bumble UV hairdresser's oil. This is the invisible oil and it's a primer. So whenever I'm using heat on my hair, I make sure to spray this in. It also helps detangle after the shower. And let's get started. So what I'm gonna do first is, again, just take my Bumble and Bumble, spray it all over my hair. And then just brush it out. Be careful not to spray too much in your roots, otherwise it'll make it greasy. We want to focus on the ends so that they are not too dry looking, or it helps mend split ends, things of that nature. Then after I brush my hair through, I'm just gonna part it. Today, I'm gonna do a side part. And now I'm gonna go in with this Revlon hairbrush dryer thing. Everybody who has one of these has raved about how amazing it is. I finally picked one up on Amazon's Prime Day, and I'm just gonna go through and get my hair totally dry because we will be straightening it after. And so I don't blow dry my hair in any specific way. I really just do it so that it is not wet anymore. And then when I go in with the straightener is when all of the frizz and whatnot that might develop from the blow dry will get smoothed out. So I'm gonna be using a high heat and okay, so now that my hair is all dry after using my blow dryer brush, 10 out of 10 would recommend, by the way. Absolutely love that product. I mean, tool. So now I'm gonna go in and straighten my hair to make it nice and smooth and pin straight so that there's no bends or anything in it like there is after blow drying it. And so I'm gonna use my Chi Iron CHI. This is just a flat iron. I don't remember the exact model name. I've had this since eighth grade and I am a graduate student in college. I'm going on 9 years of having this iron and it has not pooped out on me. It is my favorite iron and I 10 out of 10 would recommend. Hopefully they're still made as good now as they were almost 9 years ago. I do have pretty fine hair, but I do like to use a high heat just so that the process goes a little bit faster. So I will be straightening my hair at 410 degrees, but I want to make sure that I mention that that is a very high heat for somebody with fine hair. So gauge how high of a temperature you're going to straighten your hair with, depending on the type of hair that you have. If you have coarser hair, you might need that higher heat. Whereas if you have fine hair, you may put yourself at risk of damaging your hair if you're straightening at such a high heat. That's another reason why I make sure that every time before I use any heat tool, I put a bunch of heat protector in, that Bumble and Bumble product that I sprayed in before. But just be super mindful of how high the temperature is on your straightener when you're using it. So I am going to part my hair just down, turn it into two halves, just twist it up and clip it. And then I'm just gonna go around and straighten my whole head, taking pieces down as I move my way up. So for our first style, you're gonna need 2 to 4 bobby pins, depending on your hair and how many you'll need to secure it. And so these hairstyles are gonna be just a little extra addition to help make the slightest difference in your normal straight look, to just help glam it up, spice it up, make it not so just a regular straight look that you're used to wearing normally. So what we're gonna do is take one bobby pin, as you can see here, and so I'm going to take just a small section of hair in the front and separate it out and put the rest of the hair behind, and then I'm gonna focus on just this piece and I'm gonna really kind of brush it down with my fingers and tuck it behind my ear and make sure that it's nice and smooth and that it's nice. And then I'm gonna take that bobby pin and just secure it right above my ear. Might be a little hard to see because my hair is dark and the bobby pin is dark too. And then let the rest of my hair fall over. So it looks like it's tucked behind your ear, but you have your hair falling over it. So it's just a little bit, again, of that minorly enhanced look and style. So we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. And this is the finished look. Again, something super simple, super minor, but just enough to add a little extra something than what would normally be if you were just to wear your hair straight. So now that I've taken that out, our next style is again gonna require just a few bobby pins. I'm gonna use 2 on either side, so 4 total. And what I'm gonna do is on this side of my hair, so this is my right side, I'm just gonna kind of flatten it and get it into position. Take a bobby pin and just push this hair back. And to make it more secure, I'm gonna do that with a second one right above it. So it looks like that. Then on the other side, I'm gonna do the same thing, but this time I'm gonna cross it. And this is a cute, easy way to keep your hair out of your face while still having it down. For our third style, I'm gonna be using these bobby pins. I picked them up from CVS and I think they were less than $5. I love them because they are pearled and they're gold, so it's just a little bit more of a statement bobby pin than just a regular all black, brown, blonde one that you may get from the store. So what I'm gonna do is take one of the bobby pins. I'm gonna start with this one, and I'm working on the left side of my hair, which is the part that has more hair on the side. And so I'm gonna just, again, kind of brush it to the side, put it in place how I would like, and I'm gonna take the bobby pin and do essentially the same thing, except all four of the bobby pins that were just shown as the product, I'm gonna put on my hair. Again, it'll keep my hair out of my face, but still add that cute extra little style. And we have that extra pizzazz because of the fact that these bobby pins are pearls and gold. And they have a bunch of styled bobby pins. You can get them at CVS, Forever 21, a bunch of different stores. And honestly, even if you just left one, it would still look cute. You could put the other one on this side. You can get so creative with these little guys. And again, even two just looks cute, but I'm gonna do all four for this side. And these bobby pins are super strong and secure, so they should be good to stay in your hair for the entire day without moving much, which is super nice. If you wanted to add something to the other side, you could even just take your regular bobby pins and do what we just did by just popping a couple along the top so that that hair is out of your face. And you have even another look. You could do the same thing except with these. Take two of these and put them on this side. You can do so many things. They're so great. And our final look is going to involve that clear rubber band again. And all I'm gonna do is brush my hair back with my fingers and take from my eyebrows up this little piece of front hair, we could call it. And I'm just kind of gonna brush it with my fingers to smooth it out. And then I'm gonna take my rubber band and tie it back. And then I'm gonna just pull it so that it makes it a little messy. Brush the rest out. And here you have your final look that'll keep your hair out of your face while keeping the rest of it down. You could also move this higher and give yourself more of a, like, and here you have your final style. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for the next one.